Do you find yourself answering the same questions from your students' parents over and over again? Well, let me show you how to save time with an AI agent from Jotform Enterprise. Hey, Jotformers, welcome back. I'm Kimberly. And like I mentioned, if you spend more time answering questions than you do teaching, you definitely need an AI agent. This can be available 24/7 to answer all of your students' parents' questions. And it can even offer relevant information at the right time. It's simple to set up, doesn't take long at all, and it's going to become an invaluable resource for your students' parents. So as you can see, I'm currently in the desktop version of my team's workspace, and we're gonna create an AI agent by going to the top left-hand corner. We're going to create, then we're gonna come right here to AI agent, and you can see right here, it says describe your agent. Now, if you know anything about AI, the more information you can give it, the better, but I'm gonna do a quick paste. I'd like an AI agent to answer FAQs for my students' parents. Let's go ahead and create. We can see it's crafting our perfect agent. It's customizing conversations to match our needs, enhancing intelligence for accurate and helpful resources, and it's training our agent to understand responses. All right, we are officially going to land in the build tab of our AI agent. Now, almost everything on this screen is editable. On the left-hand side, you can see there's different channels that you can put this single AI agent on. I'm gonna jump down to the standalone tab. And like I mentioned, almost everything on here is editable. So we can click here and we can turn off this AI generated message and we can have something very specific that's going to show every single time. We can also have buttons that would show because sometimes our parents really don't know how they can use this AI agent. So if you want to add a button, you can. Next, we can X out of this right here and we can click on our paint roller. And this is where we can change how Clara, our parent support assistant, looks. We can scroll through our avatar gallery. Maybe we want to generate one from scratch, or we can even have her wearing our school colors. Next tab to the right is the style tab. So if we want to change the color again to fit our school branding, we can absolutely do that from here. But let me show you how you can train Clara to answer all these questions for your parents. So in the very, very top, we're going to jump over to the train tab. And you can see we automatically land in the knowledge base. And this is where you're going to give it all the information that it needs. So the first one is going to be knowledge. So if you want to add in a list of specific things, like right here, it says customer FAQs. If you have specific parent FAQs, you can add them in here. If I jump back, we have files. So if you have a PDF, a guide, a manual, maybe a classroom handbook, you can absolutely add those files here. If I head back, we have a link. Maybe you have a website for your school or your class. You can add in the link there and it will recrawl periodically. And then we have questions and answers. So if you know that you're going to get a very specific question over and over and over again, this is going to be the best place to put it. You'll put your question up here and the answer to that question in the bottom. Now, if I head back, there are some more sources if you want, maybe a YouTube channel, Zendesk, or Freshdesk, but for the most part, majority of your questions can be handled with these top four. Now, if you want your AI agent to share a specific document as they're chatting, so let's say a field trip policy form. Over on the left-hand side, we can choose actions and we can choose when. So when a user talks about, and we'll put in field trip, we want to fill out a form. And from here, you can choose that field trip form. Now, in order to share this AI agent with your parents, again, we're gonna go up to the very, very top. We're gonna jump over to publish. We're currently in the standalone option, but if you want to share specific ones, maybe a chatbot version, you can do that. Standalone is probably gonna be your best bet though. We can come right over here, click copy link, and we can share through the appropriate channels. If you want, you can upload a CSV of your parents' emails and invite them via email. Another thing you can do is you can change the settings of your AI agent. So if you want this to be a private agent, you only want the parents of your students having access, you can do that here. Now, if you want more automation for your AI agent, I'm actually gonna jump back over into that train tab, and over on the left-hand side, we have tools. So if you're having your parents upload a PDF or a document, you can pretty much integrate your AI agent with Google Drive, Dropbox, Box. If you're having them submit pictures, you can have them do that. Maybe you want to have them book time on your calendar. All of that is within the tools tab. On the left-hand side, again, if you want to add in specific forms that your AI agent can fill out for you while they're having that conversation, you can choose from your available forms. And last is teacher agent. I highly suggest utilizing the teacher agent option before you push it out. Have those conversations that you're normally having. Ask it those questions. So that way, if for any reason the AI agent doesn't know how to answer that question, you can say, hey, add that to your knowledge base so that way you know how to answer it going forward. Now, last, we're gonna jump up to that AI persona tab. This is where you can change your AI agent's name, their role, their default language, their tone of voice, how chatty they are, as well as give some chat guidelines. And it's as simple as that. By automatically answering the questions that you get from your students' parents 24/7, your AI agent can eliminate that busy work that's going to distract from teaching. Your AI agent will quickly become an essential teaching assistant supporting your teaching efforts, whether it's after hours or you're busy in the classroom. If you have any questions about how you can use AI agents in the classroom, let us know down below in the comments. If you like this video and you got some value, hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the bell so you get a notification every time we put out a new video. I'll see you next time.